Welcome to the e-learning session, Class 4, Computer, Its Classification. The topics that we are going to learn in this chapter are as follows. Introduction, classification of computers, according to purpose, size, other types of devices like smartphone, e-reader, smartwatch, digital camera, and game console. Now we know that a computer is an electronic machine that takes instructions from us and gives the result after processing them. Now this is called as IPO cycle. Now we have learned about IPO cycle in our previous class. We also know that it works very fast and can do millions of tasks in seconds. It can be classified in different ways according to shape, size, and also according to its working. Now let's see classification of computers. Computers can be classified into two types. One, according to purpose, and second, according to size. Now when I talk about purpose, there are three types how we can classify the computer: analog, digital, and hybrid. And when we talk about size, there are five different types how a computer can be classified: supercomputer, mainframe, server, microcomputer, and mobile device. We are going to see about each one of them one by one. According to purpose, analog computer. It takes different inputs. It gives us approximate result and it works on the principle of analogous data, which means I need two different things which are similar in nature so that it is easier for me to compare and come with a common result. Now this is an example of an analog computer. Now this is nothing but an analog clock. The other examples are voltmeter. It is used for measuring electric potential in volts. Now we have seen this kind of instrument with electrician. Speedometer. These are available in our cars and bikes, which is used to measure the speed of the vehicle. Fuel gauge is used to measure the amount of fuel in a fuel tank. And clinical thermometer, which is used to measure human body temperature. So these are some of the examples of analog computer. Now let's see digital computer. Now digital computer, it works on the principle of binary mathematics. That means whatever calculations you do, it is always going to represent in terms of 0 and 1. Now what is binary? We are going to see in our next slide. Now as in case of digital computer, whatever output we get, it is going to be an exact result. And that is one of the difference between analog and digital computer, like your digital watch. You can see the exact time 3:33. Your laptop, this is also based on digital computing. Now let's see what are binary numbers. Now as the name suggests, bi means two. That means it is made up of only zeros and ones. Now this is an example. 110100. Do you know what does this mean? We don't know. So that means if I give any kind of input to the computer, computer is not going to understand the way we speak. It is going to convert each and every input in the form of binary numbers in the form of 0 and 1. So there is no such 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9 in binary. Whatever it is there, it is everything divided in terms of zeros and ones. Now binary numbers, they are used in mathematics and digital electronics. They have a beautiful and elegant pattern. So this is an example of a pattern where you can see there are so many zeros and ones. Now as I said, now for example, if I want to write number 7, the moment I type 7, how it is going to go inside the computer? The computer is not going to understand what is 7. The moment I type 7, it is going to convert that 7 in the form of binary, and the conversion is nothing but 111. So the moment it goes as 111, it means this is nothing but number 7. So this is applicable in case of alphabets also. Now there is a separate calculation to derive from decimal to binary. The next type of computer is hybrid computers. Now, hybrid means combination of both analog and digital computers. Now, they are cost-effective method and they are used to perform complex calculations. Like your ECG machines, they are used to measure heartbeats of patients. Your weather forecasting, it all depends on hybrid computer. Now, do you know the first electronic digital computing device is Atanasoff Berry computer known as ABC. So this is the first digital computing device. You can see how huge it is. And the first digital watch is in Hamilton. And the biggest digital clock, you can find it in Germany. Activity time. Now, since you have learned what is analog and digital computer, what I want you to do is find the difference between analog and digital computer. Also, find examples of analog, digital and hybrid computer in real life. Now, let's go to the next part of the topic, that is according to size. The first type of computer according to size is supercomputer. So as the name suggests, supercomputer, they are the biggest and most powerful computers and they are very, very expensive. Now, since they are biggest and powerful, they are used to perform large and complex calculations and they run at a very high speed. Now, the size of the supercomputer is as big as the size of a room. You can see in the figure how big it is. So these are used in big, big organizations. The speed of the computer, it can process 1 trillion instructions per second. And that's why they are mainly used in weather forecasting, nuclear power stations, research and animation movies. The first supercomputer was developed by USA called Cray-1. India also has its first supercomputer, Param 10,000 and Anurag. The world's fastest supercomputer is Cray XT5, known as Jaguar. So this is a list of top 10 supercomputers. Activity time. Find different types of supercomputers of India. I want you to paste the pictures of these type of computers, name them and write one line on each of its usage. I want you to do this activity on A4 size paper. The next is mainframe computers. Now, mainframe computers, they are also large and powerful computers, but they are less powerful than supercomputers. They are expensive and they have the capacity to hold multiple operating systems. Now, we have learned what is operating system. That means in the same computer, I can have different kind of OS like Windows 7, Windows XP, Linux. So that is the capacity of a mainframe computer. It was developed by IBM. And the size of these computers is normally the size of a closet. It's like the size of a wardrobe. You can see it in the figure. These are mainly used in business houses and government centers. They can process millions of instructions per second. They are used in scientific research and doing bulk mathematical operations. Now, the next type of computer that we have is server. Now, this is the figure of the server. Now, server is the lifeline of any network. It controls all the hardware, software, and other resources on a computer. It provides a centralized storage area for programs, data, and information. It is small and big in size, depends upon its usage. They are used in offices, banks, and schools, and the speed of server is increasing day by day. So you can connect 2 to 1,000 types of computers at the same time. Now, the best example of our server is Smart One. Now, Smart One is a machine which is present in our knowledge center. And from our respective classes, we try to access Smart One. So Smart One is nothing but a central server through which we are accessing all our videos and our PPTs. Microcomputer. Microcomputer is also known as personal computer. It is an important part of this computer is a microprocessor, that is the brain. We can connect many peripherals such as keyboard, mouse, and monitor. Desktops and notebooks are the different types of microcomputer. Now, the size of this computer is small enough that it can be used by a single person. These are used in homes, schools, and offices. The speed is increasing day by day, and you can do basic calculations, create documents, keep records, and many more. Mobile devices. Now, these are used to store data permanently on a memory inside it or on a small storage media such as memory cards. Now, these kind of cards, we find it in our mobile devices. These are called as SD cards. Now, they are small enough to carry in a bag or a pocket. You can find them everywhere. The speed is increasing day by day, and you can connect them to your normal PCs and exchange your information. The next is the tablet PC. Now, it's a special type of portable computer. It works with touchscreen technology. Sometimes you can use the screen with the help of a touchscreen, or you have a digital pen. Nowadays, latest tablets, they more or less resemble to smartphones. The only difference is they are larger than the smartphones. Now, Windows 10 has a capacity to convert its screen in a tablet mode. So this is the normal desktop screen. So if I want to convert it into tablet mode, there is an option called as tablet mode. So the moment I click on the tablet mode, it's going to look like this. This is how your desktop looks in your tablet mode. Next is a smartphone. So it is an internet enabled phone. It allows us to send and receive email messages and access internet with a basic additional fee. It has basic phone facilities. And many smartphones have functions like media player, digital camera to capture images and share with others. Do you know this is the first smartphone that was created? So Ericsson was the first brand to create a smartphone called as GS88 in 1997. So Nokia also has its own smartphone called as Nokia 9000 Communicator. So these are also the different types of smartphones, BlackBerry and Nokia E90. Next is the e-book reader. Yes, Kindle is nothing but an e-book reader. So e-book or an electronic book is a handheld device which are mainly used for reading e-books. Now it is an electronic version of a printed book. Most of these e-books are touchscreen and internet enabled. So we have a Kindle app through which we can read our ebooks. So there are many ebook inventors. So these are some of the ebook inventors. So the first ebook was created for US Department of Defense. So this is the first ebook that it was created. Next is the smartwatch. It is a mobile device with a touchscreen display. It is designed to be worn on the wrist. It can work on its own or it can be paired with a smartphone. It shows time. It can track physical activities, show notifications like emails, messages, calls, and other networks. It is nothing but a mini computer. So the first smartphone was created by Steve Mann. So this is the first smartphone that was created. He is also known as the father of wearable computing. And the next is the digital camera. So it is a mobile device which allows you to take pictures, store photographs digitally. Nowadays, digital cameras, they are Wi-Fi enabled. You can download the copy of the image from the digital camera to your hard disk of the computer. Then we have game console. So it is a mobile computing device designed for single player or multiple player video games. So here you have a handheld device which is used as an input and TV as your output, and then you have memory cards which is used for storage. So the popular models of game consoles are MS, Xbox 360, PlayStation. So this is an example of how a game console looks. So here is a self-assessment for you. Fill in the blanks, read the questions carefully and answer the questions. Answer the following. Give me the difference between supercomputer and mainframe. a brief description on server and the different types of computers that are classified according to size. And here is an application-based question. Vicky and his grandfather visited the hospital. In the hospital, doctor was checking the heartbeat of his grandfather. You have to tell me the name of the machine and which type of computing it belongs to. Also, identify the name of the machine which is used to process trillions of instructions per second. I hope you enjoyed the session. Thank you.